only relatively unshaded part of the boat is up high and aft like this. And so if you want to get the maximum out of the solar panel, you need to have it back here, as well as be able to rotate it and angle it towards the sun when you need maximum output. Otherwise, you can just leave it horizontal, centered like that. This latest version of the solar tracker has rubber corner caps on it, so if you're down here and you come up and forget the solar panels there, you won't cut your head on these sharp corners. We've got a stainless angle bar here and here, attached with quarter-inch bolts with nylon washers to isolate from the aluminum frame. And we've cut off the large, I think they're called MC4 connectors, because they won't pass through the hole to go in the tube if you want to take them off for storage quickly. So we just cut those off and replaced them with crimp-on spade connectors, and then rigging tape over them to waterproof them. And that way, if you have a hurricane threat or just long-term storage, you can cut the tape off, unplug them, and loosen this handle, pull this safety line off, and you can take the panel off and let the wire feed down here as it's coming up. And here we've got a welded bracket and 3/8 bolts that also have nylon washers in them, and they can be retensioned if they ever become loose. They're held secure with nylock nuts on there, and so they can be adjusted. And then this knob here for adjusting the rotation. And one of the reasons for this safety line here is so that if you're rotating the panels over time, you're not going to keep rotating it too far in one direction. This will stop you before the wire inside gets twisted up too far. Here I have a bracket by Garhauer for 1¼-inch tube to 1-inch push pit rail. And at the bottom we have a universal U-bracket for the base, and the wire passes through a hole in the center, and that can be pivoted to any deck angle, even could go horizontally here or vertically here on the combing side. This bracket here fits up tight against the push pit when you can mount the tube vertically in a location that fits it. Otherwise, this adapter piece can be put on a standoff bracket, and it can be cut short to any length. Rotating the panel towards the sun will increase the output by 30% or more, and you can even start tracking the sun soon after sunrise instead of waiting for the sun to get up high. And if you're on one tack or the other and the boat's heeled, this is the only way to get the solar panel to have some decent output. Otherwise, if you are tacked away from the sun, you might as well have your panel like that with its back to the sun, because you're not going to get much, if any, output. This way you can maximize the small solar output on a boat that doesn't have a lot of space for more solar panels. Putting together two solar tracker mounts for a boat here, and we've got one assembled. Here's the components for it. That's the upper assembly. These here started out as regular mill finish, and we polished them to get it like that because you get less surface rust on them. Even though they're 316, they look better polished. And these are 1/8 by 3/4 angle, and this is 3/16 by 2-inch flat plate that's been bent, and then this is a 1.5-inch thick walled tube welded onto it. And here is the leg. It's got a universal U-bracket on the bottom, so you can position it in any direction, even a sideways mount like that, and the wire can go down through the holes in the bottom. So these are the Renogy 50-watt panels. This is a newer version, which is a little bit smaller, but the same wattage than the ones I bought about 1.5 years ago. This is a 1.25-inch to 1-inch pulpit mount bracket, so that when this 1.25-inch tube goes through there, you can clamp that onto the push pit rail. This wire coming out here will go through there, and that acts as a stop so that you don't over rotate it beyond 360 degrees in any one direction, and that will prevent the wire which goes down inside from getting tangled up. It also is a theft deterrent and a weight safety line so that the thing doesn't fall off. There's the hole in the top that the wires can go through. Now these panels come with these special connectors, but I've cut them off because they're way too big to fit through the hole. And if you want to be able to remove the panels for long-term storage or for hurricane coming, then it's easy just to disconnect with some spade connectors the electric wires and lift the panels right off and leave the poles on the boat. And these are some corner protectors which I glued on with 3M super weather strip adhesive, and I put the padding on the lower side because when you're gonna hit your head and injure yourself is if you're leaned over and you want to come up and you forget the panels above you.